Okay, so this has been the most difficult video for me to put together and upload because the topic is so personal and is something that consumed 2 years of my entire life. I want this video to be an introduction of sorts to a whole new dimension of this channel, entirely focused on promoting the importance of having a healthy mind as well as a healthy body and of finding balance in your life to reach true happiness. A happy person is a beautiful person, and finding your balance needs to be given a priority. I'm aware that eating disorders have become extremely common in recent years, and I'm very well researched and experienced in this area. I'm not a dietitian or a psychologist, however I've got a Bachelor of Science in Education, and I want to put that to good use by utilising this platform that I've created for myself on YouTube to help others through what I went through. So this video is me taking that first step in putting my story out there of my struggles with anxiety and depression, and then body dysmorphia, orthorexia and binge eating disorder. I'm now at the happiest and healthiest I've ever been in both body and mind, and every person on this earth deserves to reach this state of mind. So if you're dealing with any of these issues, please subscribe and follow along with me as I share my journey. Here is a summary of my story, accompanied by video clips that demonstrate what life is like after an eating disorder. Normal food! Once you're free from the food trap, you'll learn to embrace all that life throws at you and to be truly happy within the skin you're in. So here we go! Like so many others, I was a junk food baby, a scrawny child and an average teenager. I became depressed, developed anxiety disorder, and turned to my old faithful, my best friend, food. I quickly ballooned. I upsized my wardrobe, going from a healthy 9 stone to 13 stone. I became more depressed. One night, both my love handles reached either side of the bathtub, preventing it from filling up. I had a moment of realization. I was overweight, unhealthy, and I needed to change. I couldn't walk for 5 minutes without being out of breath. I ate all day, every day, and all the wrong things. After several failed diet attempts, I decided to educate myself. I found YouTube and weight loss blogs, and I learned to cook. My brain filled with common sense. I took baby steps to reach my goal. Good nutrition and exercise. I lost 60 pounds in 2 years. There were bumps along the way, but eventually things level out. I was healthy, I could run 10 kilometers, and I looked great. But it wasn't enough. I wasn't content. I didn't realize it was time to stop, and I had no idea what normal eating was. I cut back even more. I worked out harder. I became fixated on the scale. I became orthorexic, fearing all foods that were deemed by me to be unhealthy and unclean. I became depressed again. I developed anxiety issues again. It affected my relationships, social life, and every waking moment was consumed by food. Glorious food. Then it began. The binges. Secret at first, but then relentless. I'd be good for a few days, and then I couldn't keep my cravings in check, so I'd reward myself. My reward would become my undoing, my living hell. I'd scoff upwards of 10,000 calories of refined, sugary, fatty, carby food in a couple of hours. The gloves were off, my rules thrown out the window against a heavy wind. I'd eat until no more would fit in, on autopilot, like a robot. I'd cry sometimes, during and after. I'd eat until I couldn't move and couldn't walk, until I hated myself. You deserve this, I'd think. A dangerous method of self-harm. I even tried to make myself sick when it was really painful, but I just couldn't do it. So I'd vow to be extra good that week, and the cycle would start again. Go to sleep. Eat. Think of food. Eat. Think of food. Eat. Go to bed again. Good day. Binge day. 5 good days. 2 binge days. 1 good day. 14 binge days. My food diaries just say it all, really. Although my weight stayed in a healthy range, this continued for about 2 years. But enough was enough. I wanted to enjoy food again, for normal thoughts to come back, to enjoy social events, and to look in the mirror and just love my body no matter what. I was a girl on a mission to find happiness, recover and take my life back. So please like this video and subscribe if you want to know what I did to get over this horrible, just horrible problem. I know there's loads of you with it, and I understand. My name is Melanie Murphy. I'm 24, I'm Irish, and I've been struggling with acne for 10 years of my life. Growing up with an acne problem was extremely hard on me. I was bullied, I was insecure, and I felt alone. When society views something that you have that is out of your control as a flaw,